apply the Laplace transform of this equation. So you can see we have the f of t and the integral involved. So without the integral, let me take that back. For the integral, you could evaluate this one and then do some compile item, do some simplification. You get f of t, but that would be lengthy, and I want and add you and as you part of as you have seen my videos for a long time, I like to work with something that's simple, okay? So what I'm gonna do is to use the Laplace transform, and in order to do that, I need to rewrite this. I need somehow to manipulate this. So if you still remember, we have the convolution method, and we have convolution theorem, and in order to use that theorem, you need to have the integral two functions, one in terms of u and the other one in terms of t minus u. So for this one, you can see that we have function in terms of u, but this is slightly in terms of t minus u unless they are switched position, okay? So if they switch position, I would have the integral from 0 to t negative of, let me pass it a factor around negative 1, and I have t minus u cubed applied to the negative as well, okay? And f of u, du, don't forget to bring down the negative 8 third. So for this one, negative 1 cubed, it becomes a negative 1, and negative 1 with the negative in front would make it positive e third. And for this one, I have so this is a different way of writing convolution, and that should be t cubed convoluted with f of t. Okay? So now you have everything in terms of t. So I can take the Laplace transform on both sides. On the left side, I have f of t, f of s equals, on the right side, I have l, this is 1 over s, l of this is 1 over s squared, l of plus 8 third, l of this is 3 factorial over s to the 4th, okay? Times capital f of s. Alright, so we have capital f of s on both sides. What I'm gonna do is to bring it to one side and factor it out. So let me move this to the left side and factor it out. Then I have capital f of s times 1 minus. Okay, watch out here. So 3 factorial equals 3 times 2 times 1. So 3 cancel out, and 8 times 2 is 16. So I have 16 over s to the 4th. Okay? And for this one, we'll just rewrite it. 1 over s plus 1 over s squared. Alright? Now, as you see, we have fraction here, and again, I don't like to work with fraction. So what I'm going to do is multiply both sides by s to the 4th. Okay, then I have capital F of s to the 4th minus 16 equals s cubed plus s squared. Alright, now divide both sides by s to the 4th minus 16. So I have s cubed over s to the 4th minus 16 plus s squared over s to the 4th minus 16. Or actually, combine all these together. Yeah, just s cubed plus s squared. All over that. Alright, get rid of this, combine all these together. So basically you have this, divide by this. Okay. Now for this one, if I split it out into two fractions like this, I also couldn't be able to find the Laplace, the L inverse of it. So what we have to do is to use partial fraction decomposition method. And before I do that, I noticed that I have s to the 4th minus 16, which is the different of squared. So I'm going to write this down. So if you let me show you something here. So you have a squared minus b squared. That's going to be a minus b. A plus b times a minus b, right? Now what about to the 4th? So if you have to the 4th, that's going to be a squared minus b squared, right? So inside you have a squared plus b squared times a squared minus b squared. And a squared minus b squared is this one, so you have 3 factors here, right? A plus b, a minus b, right? Same thing here, apply it to here. So I have s cubed plus s squared over s squared plus 4 times s minus s plus 2 times s minus 2. Okay, so just because I already showed you how to get this, so if you don't get it, you can spend your time to do it step by step like this, and you would get this. Okay, so now let me use a decomposition method to find fractions of this. Now let me do it down here. So s cubed plus s squared over s squared plus 4 times s plus 2 times s minus 2. This can be obtained from the summation of a over s minus 2 plus b over s plus 2 plus c s plus d over s squared plus 4, okay? Since the LCD is everything on the denominator here, so multiply both sides by that LCD. Then I have s cubed plus s squared equals a times s plus 2 s squared plus 4 plus b times s minus 2 s squared plus 4 plus c s plus d times s minus 2 s plus 2. Okay? Now, normally you would multiply this out and find the values for each individual letters by adding some specific numbers, but I wouldn't do that because what I'm gonna do is to use a limit, because we're in calculus and you need to be wise, okay? Work smart, don't work hard. Alright, let s approach negative 2. On the left side, I have negative 8 plus 4, negative 4. Equals, so s approaches negative 2, is eliminate this, and this, so left with this, so negative 2, negative 2, negative 4, and negative 4, and this 8, so 4b. Wait a minute. Oh, 8 times negative 4, which is negative 32, b, then b equals 1/8, okay? Let's s approach positive 2, on the left side, I have a plus 4, 12. On the right side, it eliminates this and this, so I left with this. 2 plus 2, 4. 4 times 8, 32 again. So A equals 1/8. Alright, and actually 3/8. So divide this by 4. 12 divided by 32. So divide this by 4, this by 4. Okay. Now, there's no more time for us to use the limit. So I'm going to fall back to equating coefficient. Let's take a look at the leading coefficient of S cubed, the highest exponent. On the left side, I have 1. On the right side, I have A. S times S squared, S cubed, A, plus B, plus C. Okay, so we know A, B. We can find C, which is 1/8, 1/8, 1/2. So 1/2. Okay, now take a look at the leading coefficient of S to the 0. On the left side, I have 0. You can do whatever order you like, S squared, S cubed, S squared, S to the first, S is 0, but I just want to find specific one using the most easiest one, so you know A, B, C, so 1, 2, 5, D, which correspond to the leading coefficient of S to the 0, okay? So for this one, I would have 8A, 8A, this one, negative 8B, this one, 40, minus 40, so A, B, we know A, we know B, so D is going to be 1 minus 3 is negative 2, -2.5. Is it? Let's double check. A, B, A, 3, 8. Oh yeah, that's right. +1/2. Alright, we know all the values. Let it back in here. Let me do it additional step right here. So A is 3/8 over S minus 2 plus B is 1/8. Over s plus 2 plus c. So I'm going to split this out into two fractions. So I have 1/2 s over s squared plus 4 plus 1/2 over s squared plus 4. Okay. Now back to this one. Oh, actually, I need to bring this up here. Shoot. So let me just rewrite this because this is this equals this. just wait time. Sorry about that. Actually, I don't have to do this, but for some people, they don't see it, so I had to just write it right here so they can see it clearly and easily. Right, now the Laplace transform, take the error bus on both sides, so I have f of t equals 3a to the 2t, okay? This one, I have 1/8 e to the negative 2t. This one, so this is cosine, so +1/2 cosine of 2t. And for this one, we need to have 2 to make psi. But initially, it doesn't have 2. When I put the 2 in on top, I need to have the 2 on the bottom to compensate. So 2 divided by 2, which is 1, right? So 1/2 divided by 2, which is 1/4. And this is just psi of 2t. Alright, so this is your final solution eventually. That's it. If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.